Joining us now on Balance of Power on Bloomberg TV and radio is former NASA astronaut and ISS commander Leroy Chiao. Commander Chiao, welcome to Bloomberg. It's great to have you. What exactly would a Space National Guard do? Do we have an immediate need for this?
Well, some years ago when the Space Force was created, you know, there was a little bit of question, certainly in my mind, too, as to, well, is something not working with Air Force Space Command that we need to create a separate, Space Force? And, well, anyway, it did happen, obviously, and it seems to be working fine. As far as the National Guard goes, well, you know, I think it would be analogous to the way we have an Air National Guard and also an Army National Guard. And so it would make sense now that we've created a Space Force to go ahead and parallel the functions that the Air and the Army National Guards provide, you know, the same kind of complementary support that they provide for those services would also apply to the Space Force.
I do wonder about recruitment for something like this, especially given some of the issues that those who are currently up in outer space are experiencing, specifically two astronauts who, of course, went to the International Space Station on a Boeing Starliner thinking they were going to be up there for about a week. They're now not going to come home until February, and they're not doing it on a Boeing spacecraft. SpaceX is going to have to be the ones to bring them home. What is your take, sir, on what exactly happened here and the idea that SpaceX is the one that's having to pick up Boeing's pieces here?
Well, sure. You know, a number of years ago, approximately 10 years ago, Boeing and SpaceX were given contracts to provide or to help them develop these spacecraft so that they could provide services for bringing astronauts to and from the ISS. And in fact, Boeing's contract was not quite twice as much, but it was close to twice as much as SpaceX got. Back then, Boeing was seen as, hey, they're the big boys. They're the ones that can do it. They're going to be more expensive. We like SpaceX, but they're a little bit of an unknown quantity. As it turns out, SpaceX has been flying now astronauts to and from ISS for around 4 years. And so Starliner's had a bunch of technical problems, programmatic problems, cost overruns. Boeing is about $1.6 billion out of their own money. You know, these were fixed price contracts. And now it's suffering technical problems on orbit. And the NASA engineers, basically the technical team, didn't have the confidence of bringing the crew back down on that vehicle so long as there was an option, another way to get them back. And that other way is by using a SpaceX spacecraft, mm-hmm. which is well proven now. It's been delivering cargo for even longer, much longer than crew. But, you know, the Crew 9 mission that is about to launch in a few weeks, two of the four members of that crew have been taken off or will be taken off. And then Butch and Sonny, the two astronauts who are up there now, they will basically drop in and take their place, serving what would have been their six-month mission. And that's why their delay is in coming home is until February 2025.
Well, I do wonder about the personal toll that may take on an astronaut who has to completely readjust to the amount of time that they're spending in space. But this is a business channel, Commander Chiao, and obviously we do pay attention to especially public companies like Boeing, who have had credibility with issues for their just commercial airliners. Now questions around their spacecraft. Would you be comfortable getting on a Boeing ship at this point?
Well, they have obviously had a lot of problems on their commercial airplane side and now on their space side as well. And in fact, those problems, as we just talked about, aren't new. But they've also just recently got a new CEO, and this person has been tasked with changing the culture back to the way Boeing used to be. Boeing used to be an engineering-led company. Safety was the top priority, and they built the best commercial airplanes in the world back then, not that long ago. And also they built, you know, they're very busy in the space, both the civil and the military space businesses as well. And so hopefully this person will be able to effect those kinds of changes and culturally bring Boeing back from more of an engineering-led company rather than what they've become, which was a bottom-line-led company. So, you know, I think they can do it. It's obviously not easy to change the culture of a large organization, but it's obviously veered off, in the wrong direction. And so we'll see if they can bring it back.
And finally, sir, we just have about 90 seconds left, but on the other side of this, SpaceX, of course, not just bringing those astronauts home, but getting ready as soon as tomorrow to launch the Polaris Dawn mission, in which we could see the first ever commercial spacewalk happen. Commander Chiao, do private citizens have any business walking in space?
Well, I'll tell you, it did raise some eyebrows. You know, my specialty at NASA was doing spacewalks. I did six, mm-hmm. four in American, two in Russian suits to help build the station. So, but on the other hand, you know, I know the folks at SpaceX. I know they take safety very seriously. Technically, they're excellent. So I have every confidence that this will go off okay. Nonetheless, as you pointed out, having a non-professional crew do this with a new spacesuit and bringing the ship down to vacuum in order to do it does entail additional risk. But as I said, I know SpaceX. I know the folks there. And I have good confidence that they'll be able to get it done.
Well, and it's great to hear from someone who has some experience with spacewalks himself. Commander Leroy Chiao, thank you so much for joining us.